Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. Let's see what it looks like on the page. Oh, there I am. Let's see if I can hear it. Pretty good. Good. Let me just get it onto the relevant page so I can do comments. One person's tuned in. All right, I'm on there. Tap on there. Tap on there. Swipe left to reveal comments. There we go. We are good to go, ladies and gentlemen. Bang on 1:30, I do believe. Oh, no, we're a minute early. Bloody hell, I'm never early for anything. Makes a change, doesn't it? Good health to all one of you that's tuned in apart from me. Oh, three of you, actually. Good health. Do please say hello if you're here. Have a wave. Let's see who's tuned in. Getting, as I said before, I get so many plays later on in the week, people who tune in and watch it while they do the washing up or whatever. Many of them are for a minute when I look back at the analytics, but it's nice to see when people are looking longer than a minute. Because here we are, Songs and Stories number 57. It's about an hour show of me singing some songs and telling you what I've been up to. And yeah, I've been doing this for a long time now. I worked out it was about 28 days solid streaming. If you counted up all the hours, that's bloody insane, isn't it? What shall we open up with today? Let's open up with a bit of Steve Earle, I think. I was jamming this the other day. Hillary's there. Sorry, I'm out of the sip and paint tonight. We'll catch up later. Okay, no problem. This is Steve Earle. This is a song that me and Justin used to play, Justin Prescott, the Tannerfest man, the Deviant Amps man, when we were in Treehouse together. And we used to jam this. Let's see if I can remember it. Heard that love is blind, I know that there's another kind, shines like a beacon in the night, up in the morning light. In my dreams travels with me when I run, but in my dreams she takes my hand when I make my stand. When the morning always comes, I know it's good you to be true. Keep on searching far and wide. I know she's out there somewhere now. I'm gone. gonna track her down somehow. Cause in my dreams, she travels with me when I run. And in my dreams, she takes my hand when I make my stand. When the morning always comes, I know it's too good to be true. Me even when I'm blue. Cause in my dreams, she travels with me when I run. And in my dreams, my hand when I make my stand. When the morning always comes, I know it's too good to be true. She loves me even when I'm blue. She loves me even when. Steve Earle there for you, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see who's tuned in. James Sexton, hello boy, good evening to his good lady wife Diane and Roger Morgan. Hello bud, bit late. Do I get a tardy slip? You do indeed, mate. Sit in the corner and do some lines. So that makes four people watching at the moment. It's nice to have people who are live. Yeah, I love that song. God, it's so cool. I've made a little list of some songs that I play. I don't know what I'm going to talk about tonight, really. I don't know. It's like I've spent a lot of time promoting stuff online, really. Doing a campaign for the single Genuine coming up. I think, when is it? Next week, I'm doing like a Zoom interview for a couple of online TV stations that go on Apple TV for Steve Osborne Media. And Steve will be getting out with his Livewire channel, which gets out to various radio stations and kind of these kind of web TV stations across the world. So I'm looking forward to doing that next week and seeing where it takes me with that. So I've been busy doing that, been busy promoting stuff online. I did a couple of covers gigs at the weekend. Friday night I played with Mark Gill over at a new venue in Peterborough called The Shed, which was a really good fun night. Great to play with Mark again. Saturday I had off. I didn't do anything much then, apart from going for a long walk. And then Sunday, I headed over to Kidderminster and did a very chilled out Sunday afternoon gig at the Post House over there. I love Sunday afternoon gigs. They're just so chilled. You know what I mean? It's such a different type of gig. And I'd like to do more of those, please, next year. That would be marvellous. I might have a look at the diary and chase up a few venues for some more Sunday gigs. So, yeah, that's kind of what I've been up to, really. So tonight I'm just probably just going to play a few songs, really. What's next on the list? I've been very organised. I have a list of songs, proper set list tonight. I'm usually pretty organised, but I actually prepared this morning. That's how on the ball I am at the moment. Yes, I've got this one, if I can find it. And then I'll change the order slightly. Right. Cheers to you all as well. What's everybody drinking? Anyone else drinking an alcohol-free beer? Or are you on the hard stuff? Cup of tea, maybe. Right, this is on second fret, this next song. Let's get that bit right. This is a Ryan Adams song. It's one that me and Mark used to do at the Charter when we used to run open mic there. Good memories of playing that with him then. At the same time it came out. It's called These Girls.
Sometimes I feel just like a boy. Put her on this earth for you to toy around with. Like matchbox cars you burn in your backyard. Like monsters underneath the bed you ain't afraid of yet. But I let you in and I feel alright. And I feel late night girls are anxious, coming out to play. I've been stranded on their doorstep for every night and day. The only one anymore. It's so sad, but when they smoke and I've been had, I get hypnotized and I wanna go to bed. Up shells cast off the reef. One Christmas I got a funeral, they handed me the receipt. How many lies I tell without my tongue. Get twisted into memories till I believed them some. And I toy with you, you toy with me. Could you stop this? Please. God bless all the late night girls and they're coming out to play. I've been stranded on their doorstep every night and day. My only one day more. It's so sad when they smoke and I've been bad. Makes me tired and I wanna go to bed. These girls are better off in my day. These girls, these girls, these girls are better off in my head. These girls are better off in my head. These girls are better off in my head.
Just checking the comments here. What have we got? James says, lovely alcohol, Diebel's Altbier, wunderbar. Next time when you and James do a live one, please do Deborah. Yeah, God, we should do that, James. And I'd like to learn the proper harmonica solo as well. I was digging through my my box of harmonicas the other day and trying to jam along with it. I'm not quite sure what key it is, so... If you've got an array of harmonicas, Jim, do check out what key the correct harmonica is on the song Deborah. Yeah, have a go. I should try and learn it properly because I always just jammed along with it with a G harmonica. So if anyone doesn't know what we're talking about, me and James used to play this song called Deborah by the Fat Lady Sings when we used to gig together. Diane has just requested it next time we do a live. It's a great song. It's a great album. I listened to the other day. Yeah, I love that song that I've just played for you anyway. These Girls by Ryan Adams. One of his good ones. One of his many good ones. Okay, let's do a couple of songs from the 80s.
precious heart.
INXS there for you. Roger says he's on the hard stuff. Ibuprofen picked up a bug at the Hackett gig. Oh no. Hey Jane, thank you very much indeed for tuning in. I've got a song lined up for you, Jane, at the end of the show. If you're still tuning in, but thank you very much. Yeah. So, yeah, if you're still sticking around, Jane, I've got a song I'm going to play for you. By the way, Jane bought the album recently, and thank you very much to everyone who has bought CD copies of Getting There, or on download for that matter. It means an awful lot. And glad that people are enjoying the album. And, yeah, it's really nice, particularly on the Bandcamp Friday day when I sold a couple of copies of stuff because it's commission free. And we've got 25% sale, actually, I should mention that, on all of our merch at the moment. So if you do go to the web store, go and buy something 25% off. There's some t-shirts left. There are any medium and large ones, I'm afraid, at the moment. But all the CDs are 25% off as well. So if you want to buy something, that would be great. Or even if you just want to chuck something into the tip jar, that would be amazing. Helps to pay for strings, rehearsals, patch from the car to get to our gigs. Next gig I'm doing is actually at the Lab in Northampton on the 2nd of November, which is a Saturday, supporting the wonderful Nick Harper. Really looking forward to that. Nick was one of the first sort of acts he was the first act that I supported at Musician, really. And Ian from Magic Teapot gave us that gig, and it's Ian's birthday today, so many happy returns, Ian. I doubt you're watching this, but Ian's a great guy, puts on loads of great grassroots gigs, great taste in music, And he gave me and Mark that kind of break to support Nick back in about 2004, I think it was. And then we went on and did our album launch. So yeah, thank you very much, Ian, for the opportunity, and I hope you're having a good birthday. So yeah, Saturday the 2nd of November at the Lab, buy some tickets. Right, what am I going to do now? I said I'd play another 80s song for you. This is one that I actually finished off my covers gig yesterday with, because it was a really chilled gig. And it's funny though, it's funny, I was double booked with the England game. So I'm in this pub, yeah, and there's a screen in front of me so I can watch the game. And there's a screen to the right of me as well. And of course, everyone was in to watch the football. There's a few people who are into the music, but it was a weird combination. But I didn't mind it, I could watch the game. We certainly played a bit better than what we did against Greece anyway, but only just, really, when you look at the scheme of things. Hey, it's what it is. Gabrielle there for you from about God knows some point in the early part of the 80s. It's a beautiful song. Thank you for playing INXS. Saw them twice and they were amazing. Diane, have you seen the Netflix documentary or the documentary called Mystify about Margot Hutchins in INXS? It's amazing, it really is. Opened up my eyes to a lot of stuff about him. Very sad, very tragic, that he suffered from brain damage after his injury, you know, which consequently probably led to his death, you know. But yeah, they were fantastic, and I'm very jealous that you saw them live. I'd love to have seen them. Let's do an original song for you. I might actually have said I haven't done this for so long, I might have to dig the words out for it, so bear with me. Just as backup, It's not one I play very often. It's a bit of a rarity, to be honest with you. In fact, I need to dig out the lyrics for another original song as well. So here we are. Let's play this one first anyway. CD, and also if you do scat around, you'll be able to find it on some of the streaming channels as well. That's from 2011, a duo album with me and Mark, and that was called Sometimes Love Is Not Enough. And it's about, it's about really when even if you really want to make something work with someone and it's not working, it ain't gonna happen, you know. And you can try, and yes, it's nice if it can be an amicable ending, you know. That's as much as I'll say on that, really. We used to do that with the band as well. Like, I think if you look on Stevie Jones' Bandcamp page, you'll be able to check out our first ever gig. Which was recorded in 2010, and it features on there, and Sean Clutterman is playing harmonica on it as well. So do check that out. Let's see what you've been saying. I'm trying to be interactive tonight, folks. The bloody computer will work. Computer. No, there's no one. Swipe left. Oh, there we go. Swiping the wrong way. Yes, Stein says he saw the INXS documentary. It was devastated. So tragic. Fred, greetings from Walgrave. Are you back down in the area, Fred? We'd love you to see you. Let me know. Inbox me if you want to meet up for a coffee or something. Wow. We'd love you to see you, Fred. Love you to catch up after all these years. Do let me know.
clock I stopped on the kitchen wall. Smell your scent on my pillow. I see your books upon the shelf, and I wait to leave the stupid hill. Welcome aboard, aboard the Mary Celeste. We're all a ghost come in to rest. Think of all that used to be. I feel like you would not leave, but I told you you could never be. Welcome aboard, aboard the Mary Celeste. We're all a ghost, a ghost going to
Mary Celeste from the 2007 acoustic album with Mark Gilligan, Weather the Storm. And yeah, if you haven't heard that album, it's one of the best things I think that I recorded. And certainly the best thing that me and Mark did. We just stripped it right down to a couple of acoustics and vocals and recorded it about 5 hours all live. And it really captured the time and the things that I was going through back then. Wow, only four people watching now. Bloody hell. I'm popular tonight. Ah. Oh, wow. You're on, you're on the way to see Joe Jackson on Thursday and catching up with family. Nice. Wow. Yeah, I was hoping to have gone to see Joe Jackson, Fred, at it's in Mumford, but I've had a few expenses recently, like car repairs and things like that, and I just couldn't manage it. Yeah, if I find a pot of gold at the end of the rainbow, I'll come down to the Ali Pally on Thursday. But I can't, because on Thursday I've got an announcement, actually. I'll tell you why I can't go down there on Thursday. Because we have the wonderful Sally Barker playing at the Ember Sessions in Oundle, and supported ably by the wonderful Cambridge singer-songwriter Rich Young. And yeah, it's going to be, doors are open at 7 o'clock. Tickets are still available if anyone wants to come along to that. Come and see Sally Barker, incredible singer-songwriter from Leicestershire. Was a finalist on The Voice, so she's toured with Tom Jones. She's played with Fairport and done loads of folk club stuff as well, and so it's going to be a good night. And she's, the show's actually Joni, Sandy and me, so she'll be doing Joni Mitchell and Sandy Denny songs as well as her own material. So that is what I'm doing on Thursday. Are you going, Roger? Are we going to see you there? Right. Where are we? Oh, yes, I was going to do that. I'm going to play you a song off Clarity and Dust now, which I don't do very often on acoustic. But yeah, it sounds quite nice with everything stripped down. Let's have a go.
Selling everything she owns. The rest in father's attic, some old books and some old clothes. Buzzing with excitement, the old van is in the drive. She's heading out coast to coast to leave it all behind. Step outside, the world you know. Outside. These dreams are bigger than us. We are gonna chase them anyway. It's this do or die. Will we find our way back home again? Or die. She's waiting on the visas down at the embassy. The months of forms and questions about the family. Staring at the brochures at all the properties. Beneath the stars to align to make this reality. Step outside the world you know. Step outside. These dreams are bigger than us. We are gonna chase them anyway. Is this do or die? Factory with dusty broken windows, you hold the padlock key. The waiting it is over, the lease papers are signed. Standing in the shadow up the mountain you must climb. Step outside the world you know. Step outside.
Do or Die. And like I say, we don't play that very often now with the band because we've got all these new songs to put in the set. And me and Alfie were talking the other day actually about as we get into next year and we gig then, we're probably going to mix it up a bit because we'll have showcased the stuff off the new album quite a bit. And we're going to tour next year in the spring and I'll be able to announce that soon. I'll be announcing the dates anyway. I'll spill the beans now actually for those of you listening. We're going to do a tour with Blackballed. My good friends Blackballed and Autumn Saints. And yeah, really looking forward to it. Got some really nice venues lined up. And but we just need to finalise some of the dates. Autumn Saints were lined up to support New Model Army on their autumn tour, but New Model Army have had to cancel the tour because Michael, the drummer, is hurt, is back, I think. So they've got to reschedule their dates, which might have a knock-on effect on our dates. So once that's finished, we can announce ours, once that's in place, you know. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to announcing it, though. And, yeah, we'll be able to mix up our set a little bit more than for those gigs, I think. Is that you, Lottie? Do you want to come and say hello? I bet you don't want to, do you? You're going to wriggle like a worm. There you are. Say hello. Say hello. Here she is. She has to make an appearance, doesn't she? You just wanted to show your face, didn't you? I've got a new sofa. I won't move the camera around, but it's amazing. This lovely new sofa. It's so comfy. It's so comfy. And me and the cats have been really enjoying it over the last few days. So we're all very happy in this house. Roger says he can't make Thursday the Ebony Buck and album launch. Yeah, I really wish I could go to that, mate. Bloody hell. Well, wish for all the best from me. If you do get a chance to speak to him, I'd love to be there. I have actually listened to the new album and it's really good, really good, really enjoyable. Right, where are we with time anyway? I'm kind of like a bit meandering today. Not really with it. 43 minutes, so you can play a couple more songs. Interesting thread today, if you get a chance to look at my personal profile. I opened up a discussion about BBC introducing. For the last 10 years, I've been uploading tracks and just been blanket ignored. And like, it's just really weird. I just can't get my head around why. You know, there've been some good songs, and, you know, and it's like, it's really weird when we uploaded Neon Underground, they ignored it. And then a week later, Planet Rock jumped on it and played it, gave it loads of airplay. So that was odd. Other tracks as well that you know, have been overlooked for 10 years. And then with Genuine, I just thought with the single, it's a very commercial track, you know, and it's got Jodie Erica, who's featured on BBC Introducing, doing backing vocals, and it's just baffled me. So I put up that status, and there's been some really good discussions and really good feedback from Kerry Kosh, the BBC Introducing DJ, and it transpires that they don't just have to focus on Northamptonshire now, they have to do Hearts, Beds and Bucks as well, and they're just swamped with all this music, so it must make it very difficult to create time in like an hour show or however long it is, 2 hour show, to cram all that in. I do appreciate that, but it just seems a bit bizarre. I don't know, it opened up some very interesting discussions, and my main point at the end of it was, I'm sure they've got loads and loads of artists, who are sitting at home recording stuff, you know, because it's really easy to record at home now, who aren't established, you know, and just uploading stuff on there. And they're giving them an opportunity, which is great, you know. But from where I'm standing, I'd like to see them looking around, maybe doing a bit of research on acts, thinking, right, these guys are up and coming. Let's promote their shows. They're doing a lot to promote local gigs, and that side of it doesn't seem to be happening. I don't know. BBC Introducing isn't the be all and end all. We have to carve our own paths and stuff, And I certainly do that and try and get across to as many different other platforms as possible. Jim Saw's PR media company's done a lot for me in the last couple of years, the last couple of albums. We've got on BBC Right Wales, we've got on BBC Scotland, and loads of small community stations. The Doc Mason radio show has been fantastic for me. I've been on there live, doing live streams and stuff. And you just got to go out there and look for other opportunities. And I've been doing that for 10 years without getting any airplay on my local BBC Introducing. It's very interesting, though. Very interesting discussions. I really appreciate the feedback that Kerry and her predecessor, Lal, gave. So if you get a chance to look at that on my personal profile, have a look. It's very interesting. I know James has looked at it. I generally think they can only go on the songs they receive. They've got hundreds, mate. Hundreds and hundreds of songs. And that is the problem. They're absolutely swamped. But it would be nice for them to do a little bit of research and think, oh, you know, so-and-so bands, you know, playing a lot in the area. Although there's a festival coming up. Let's have a little mention about that. But it just seems to be a bit of a pick and mix. Anyway, that's the way I see it. Let's do another song. I don't know what I'm going to do. Let's have a look. Lucky Dip, out of the book. Thank you.
touch, but what could I change when I don't write the script anyway?
The 8th of a day from the album Angels and Sirens. If you check out the studio version, it features Janet Robin on guitar. Right, let's finish off with an audio song. Let's just see what people have been saying. Oh man. Right, I know. So this is exactly the problem. Only able to choose songs and not go to the background. Yeah, exactly, James. Yeah, it's a real problem. They need to change the model of the show, quite simply, because it isn't adequately. What's it doing? You know, what's it actually doing? It's a complete pick and mix. They need to do something with it. Definitely, it's certainly their show that they've got three counties to do pick and mix with. I don't know what kind of remit they've got. You know, what they have to do, but it's not covering the bases, is it? Anyway, get into Griff. Or I shall. Yes, if you could give him a nudge, mate. I mean, I don't know him personally. Again, like, if you don't know people, they probably don't even touch your emails. So if you know him, give him a nudge. What does Roger say about the topic? We need a show like the Oregon Whistle Test. They played all sorts of rock, established and up and coming, and that's what I wanted Afterglow Rock TV to be out. When you put on music clips, you get hit by copyright strikes on YouTube. The only way you can get around it, Roger, is to do acoustic. You're doing the interviews on your channel. You could do acoustic versions, you know, get myself, get Ebony or whoever, you know, whoever you're interviewing, because that won't touch it. I mean, I can do cover versions of all kinds of stuff here, and Facebook is fine with that. You know, it's the minute that you have audio on Facebook or on YouTube, it stings it. But acoustic versions are fine though. Anyway, I'm going to finish off with this audio song. Just got to fire up the computer a minute. Do, 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 do. Been quite a chilled live stream tonight. Sorry, I haven't had much to say. I just, I'm not in a very talkative mood, really, in terms of general stuff. How it is, isn't it? It's Monday, isn't it? And it's weird, because, like, at work, I did a late work shift. So I didn't get in till 6:30. So I kind of, like, literally had to turn on the computer and get everything ready. So I haven't really had time to kind of chill before the live stream like I usually do. But we'll be back to normal next week. So I'm just going to find that. I have to play something off the new album. I just do. Because it's out there. And if you haven't listened to the whole thing, why not? It's meant to be listened to as the whole thing, you know? Don't just dip in and out of it. It's only 30 minutes long. It tells a story. And it will take you on a little journey. And this is track 3 that I'm going to play for you. And I don't know if Jane is still listening, but she did share a lovely post and say that she thought this song was really strong, and it was a really beautiful cover version of the Waterboys song Trumpets, which is what I'm going to play for you now, if I can get the technology to work. Mm-hmm.
trumpet sound. I said, you're the field, the trumpet
Trumpets, written by Mike Scott and the Waterboys. This is the C album that we have covered for our album, Getting There. And yeah, that's a shout out for Jane. So thank you very much for tuning in. Sorry for not really being quite with it this evening. What are you doing, Cat? She's scratching the scratching post. At least she's scratching the scratching post. And not the bloody stair carpet, that's what I say. The other cat, Luna, she hasn't been too well. She's got some kind of allergy, so I've got to take to the vets on Wednesday. So I'm hoping that she's going to be okay. So I shall fill you in on that later on next week. Anyway, thank you very much for tuning in, folks, whether it's now live or later on. Your support is always appreciated. Like I say, my next gig is on Saturday the 2nd of November. Solo supporting Nick Harper. The next full band gig after that is at Mama Liz the Friday after that. I'd love to see you all there. Well, not all of you, because some of you live plenty of miles away, like different countries and stuff. But Mama Liz on the 8th of November with Liam, Vincent and the Odd Foxes, Tony Barker and the wonderful Stephen Tanner. So yeah, get down to that anyway if you are local and can make it. But if not, take care of yourselves, and I'll speak to you soon.